Hey to you. I want to welcome you back to the second episode of How I Animate in Clip Studio Paint. This episode will focus on getting your layout, or what Clip Studio Paint calls workspace, together for animation. As I'm recording this video, we're just under 600 subscribers, so please hit that subscribe button and share with anybody else that you think this video will help out. Let's get straight into it, because it's a little bit more than just a workspace. Okay, so anybody that just bought Clip and they opened it up, they're probably looking at my theme and going, this is not the same. So let me do you a favor and start off the way you started off. So you'll start off like this with a white canvas, and you want to change this because you're going to burn your eyes out from all of the reflection of the light in the screen. You already got backlights in the whatever computer screen you're looking at. So you go to File, and you're going to go to Preference, and then you're going to go to Interface, and you just change the interface color to dark. So now that we've done that, we can get started on basically setting up the layout. The first thing I want to do is start consolidating things. So we're going to get this color, and I'm going to bring these tools. You just click and hold on the dark gray area, and you're going to see that red bar, and that's just telling you where everything is going to go. So I'm going to put it right here, and I'm going to bring up my color history and everything. And I'm going to take this, see how all of these light up together? That means they're a group, a whole set. So I can take this and drag it over here. When you see that red, that's how you know that it's set for that area. Now I'll move that back out, and I'll click on this part right here where it's the sub tools, and I'll consolidate them too. Now they're in the one menu. That's sub tool, pencil, and it's whatever tool you've selected over here. Now, what I like to do is separate them, because I don't use these that much. It's usually one click. This is my go-to stuff, colors, using different tools. So I'll take this, which is layers, consolidate that. Usually put layer properties in the back because I don't use it that much. And then I can grab these tool properties and drag them down to the bottom. You see that red light up? That means they're ready to be set. So now my layers and then my sub tools are over here on this side, and the colors and all of that stuff is on that side. So I'll take this group, I'll take this group and put it behind this little quick menu. So now that menu pops out, let's close it back down by collapsing it. And then I'm gonna just take this dark gray part, click it, hold it, drag it over to here, and then fully collapse it. The two arrows, the double arrows, will collapse it completely. Boom, so now you can't see anything but that gray. So the last thing we want to do, which we did in the last video, is open a timeline. Now our timeline is set. So you can make a couple adjustments. You know, give yourself a little bit more room for the canvas, up or down, however you feel. And then to make it so you don't have to do this ever again, you can come to Windows, Workspace, and register your workspace, and you just give it a name. I'm going to name this Tut Workspace. And there you go. There you have it. You don't need to do anything else. So I can bring up something new, like we've done before, animation. And there we go. Everything is ready to go. Here go your layers, sub tools, all of this stuff, even your size here. This way you can come over here and just click on the size you want your pen or pencil, whatever you're using, chalks, brushes, all of those things. And it's as easy as that. So now you can always go and reset to default, and then click on Workspace, Tut Workspace. There you have it. And that way you always have your workspace. You can even save it up to a cloud, but I can get into that in another time. But just do me one favor. Do not highlight your workspace that you set and then reset it to default, because it will reset that workspace. Other than that, you good to go. And as always, anime life forever.
I'm doing my mom.